Hello, this is John Pennington, County Extension Agent for Agriculture and Water Quality in Washington County, and today I am going to be talking about watersheds.
The places where water from rainfall, snowmelt, or overwatering drains across land surfaces and into a common body of water, such as a pond, stream, lake, river, or even an ocean. In this diagram, the blue circled area represents the watershed area for a pond, and the blue line itself represents the watershed boundary for the land area that drains to the pond. The watershed boundary is the place that divides one watershed from another. As water drains into the pond and fills it up, the water then overflows the pond and is now part of a larger watershed area as it flows across the land surface beyond the pond outlet and toward the next body of water, such as this stream. Since the water from the pond is contributing water to a larger watershed area, the pond is actually a sub-watershed or contributing watershed for a larger drainage area. As the pond contributes to the stream also contributes or flows into another body of water that happens to be a lake in this case. The pond and the stream are both different sub-watersheds that contribute drainage water into the lake. This lake is called Lake Fayetteville, and its watershed boundary is being drawn on the screen right now. All of the water that falls within its boundaries in contributing sub-watersheds, such as the pond, drain into Lake Fayetteville. In this picture, you can clearly see that there is a city with homes, businesses, roads, and you can also see forests and farms. All of these things are commonly found in watersheds, although no two watersheds are ever exactly the same. Once the water whose journey we are following moves through the lake, it flows over the spillway and into a larger watershed drainage area. And the lake is, you guessed it, now a sub-watershed that contributes water to a larger watershed drainage area that is called the Clear Creek Watershed. The Clear Creek Watershed boundary is being drawn on the screen right now, and you can see the pond and Lake Fayetteville sub-watersheds within its boundaries, as well as many other areas in the Clear Creek watershed where water can drain into Clear Creek. Clear Creek, though, is a sub-watershed of a larger watershed area called the Illinois River Watershed. So, the Illinois River Watershed contains all of the watersheds we have seen today so far, as well as many, many, many more. As you have probably noticed by now, watersheds are filled with many sub-watersheds. And yep, you guessed it again, the Illinois River Watershed is actually a sub-watershed of the Arkansas River. The Arkansas River Watershed is bigger than any we've seen yet today, and it spans all the way from the Rocky Mountains to the Mississippi River, of which the Arkansas River is a sub-watershed. The Mississippi River watershed is the largest watershed in the United States and spans from the Rocky Mountains in the western United States to the Appalachian Mountains in the eastern United States. Within its watershed boundary are all of the watersheds we've seen today, plus hundreds of thousands, if not millions more. Of course, all of the water that drains into the Mississippi River watershed and does not get evaporated or used along its journey eventually makes its way to the Gulf of Mexico. So hopefully now you know what a watershed is and that each watershed is made up of many sub-watersheds. To find out more about watersheds or how your actions can positively impact water quality within your watershed, contact your local county extension office or watershed organization.
This podcast was funded by the Arkansas Natural Resource Commission and Environmental Protection Agency.